Mr. President, I think that this is a very welcome and a very balanced report. It allows us to restate our ironclad commitment to protect the security and the prosperity of the State of Israel, and it allows us to recognise the new threats which we will oppose from an expansionist Iran determined to build a road to the Mediterranean and determined to expand its sophisticated manufacture of missiles in South Lebanon. But this report allows us to recognise the deepening crisis affecting Palestine. It allows us to recognise the illegal settlements across nearly half of Palestinian land, the insecurity of Palestinian access to water, to power, to mobile phones. It allows us to recognise the throttling of Gaza, where our observers were denied access and where we called in Resolution 2142 for the lifting of the blockade. It allows us to recognise the scandal of Palestinian children tried in military courts, highlighted for the world to see in the case of Ahmed Tamimi this week. And it allows us to recognise the foolishness of Donald Trump's decision to move the American embassy to Jerusalem and to slash the vital help that is supplied by UNRWA. The great risk today is that a new generation of Palestinians are giving up on hope and they are giving up on the future. And we have a special responsibility to help rekindle that hope, because this assembly was born from the same determination to resist any return to the horrors of Nazi Europe that actually gave rise to the creation of the State of Israel. So I think we have a particular job to do in helping renew and redevelop a new generation of leaders on both sides, engaged in politics, in civil society and trade unions. But that requires us to remove the barriers to Palestinian organisations flourishing in civil society. It means we have to create new forums for leadership development, and crucially it means we must help develop the role of women's groups in civil society. The tragedy today is that there is a zero-sum game between security for Israel and justice for Palestine. One's advantage is another's loss. Yet in the long run, we cannot have a choice between security and justice, because in the long run, we need both. Mr. President, in the hills above Al-Walaja, there are now security walls that cut the land crossed by Mary and Joseph 2,000 years ago on their journey to Bethlehem. And there up on those security barriers, someone has sprayed the eternal truth in spray paint that all walls fall. This is the lesson of history. The only question is always how fast and at what cost. If we want both peace and justice, then we need those walls to fall, and we need to accelerate the business of building bridges. Mr. President, it is now quite clear that America is in retreat. It is therefore the duty of this assembly to advance.
Thank you, Mr. Byrne.